Hey guys, Eric Tarr here for theproaudiofiles.com. I want to show you a very cool feature of the iZotope Ozone 5 plugin. This feature is called spectrum matching. In order to understand this feature, you must first understand the idea of frequency analysis. This plugin has a frequency analyzer built in as part of the equalizer section of the plugin. So as soon as you open it up and click on this tab, you'll see the graphical user interface here display a frequency analysis. What this is going to tell you is the relative amplitude or energy of different frequencies that are part of the signal that's feeding the plugin. Right now I've got this plugin inserted on my mix bus, or as the first insert slot on my master fader here. Then I've got all these other tracks in my session feeding the mix bus, from my drums, synthesizers, acoustic guitar, electric guitar, bass, and so on, all going into this master fader. And so when I press play, the frequency analyzer is going to tell me the relative amplitude of all the frequencies of my full mix. So here it is. This frequency analysis feature on its own can be very helpful when you're trying to make decisions about doing things like equalization. It will tell you maybe where frequencies are too loud or too quiet, and help you decide whether you need to boost or cut specific frequencies. But taking this a step further, you can actually use the frequency analyzer in the plugin to match the relative amplitude of different frequencies in your mix to some other reference mix that you're using. So what I've got in my session is all my tracks going over to this particular bus called music mix. I'm going to go ahead and mute that. Then what I've done is brought in a reference track that I like to use. This is a song mix from a band called Flight Path. They're based out of Nashville. I like their sound a lot. So what I'm going to do is feed the signal from my reference track into the iZotope plugin and look at the frequency analysis here on the display of my reference track. So maybe you noticed just visually that there might have been some differences in the spectral content. Maybe there was too much highs or too little highs in my mix. And so just visually, you can probably tell some of these things. The nice thing about the iZotope Ozone plugin is it will actually remember these settings and come up with a way for you to match or automatically equalize your mix to match this reference track that you're using. So the first thing you need to do is go in and capture what are called snapshots. These snapshots are going to be used eventually later on by the plugin to figure out how it should automatically change or equalize the mix that you're feeding it. So I'll start out and capture a snapshot for my reference track. So I'll click this. All right, that should be good. Stop the capture. I can call this one the reference. Perfect, and I'll save that, and iZotope's gonna use this later on. Let me create a different snapshot then for the actual mix that I'm working on right now. That should be good. I'll call this one mix. All right, so what you can see displayed on the screen now, the purple line is the frequency analysis of my reference, and the yellow line is for the mix that I'm working on right now. You can see that there are some subtle differences, and for the most part, it's pretty close, but what I can do is use this switch over from the snapshots tab to the matching tab and have the plugin automatically figure out, well, what's the differences, what things need to be changed, using the equalizer such that my mix matches more of my reference. So I'll use this one called reference here, and I'm going to apply it to my mix. Then you have to click this match button right here. and you'll see that the equalizer automatically snaps into place. Then it's up to you to decide how much you want it to fix so I can make it more dramatic. Or you can also change how smooth it is, if it's a gradual change in the spectrum, or if it's more pronounced. Typically, you don't want all these ripples showing up when you're trying to do this matching. But what it's going to show you is my mix might have been too heavy on the low end relative to this reference that I liked, but also might not have been bright enough. If that's the particular style of music that I'm working on, then I might want to make sure that all these things are pretty consistent to other popular tracks that other people are listening to. So let's then listen to what the plugin is doing to my mix. So this is a way that you can use the frequency analyzer built in to the iZotope Ozone 5 plugin to match the spectrum for your song that you're working on with a reference track.